So there is a one question in the question box. Any reports on a COVID encephalitis? This is asked by Dr. Hemant from Patna. COVID encephalitis.
Actually, some cities, both China, Italy, they have reported a quite good number of 2 to 4%. But the problem is reporting whether it is a real encephalitis or it's because of hypoxia or metabolic dysfunction. Unless somebody is properly investigated, it's very difficult to differentiate and suggest the encephalitis. Very real. Except for few patients, the coronavirus has not been identified from the CSO. So, unless they are properly investigated, it's very difficult to say actually it's encephalitis.
More likely immune-mediated encephalitis rather than a direct viral
infection.
So, this, as sir said, that I have not came across any study where they have replicated or proven that the virus in the CSF. So it's most likely immune-mediated encephalitis, parainfectious or post-infectious that these patients have as a part of diffuse inflammation in the body.
So these are the questions which were asked. We invite anyone
to address the first question. Is a post-COVID neurology complication. We have talked in a detail about it, and the final comment is going from Dr. Suresh Gupta. Is going to tell about the treatment of post-COVID neurological complication. Dr. Suresh, would you like to answer this question?
This one,
the first one.
Treatment of post-COVID
neurological
complications.
Yeah.
So the treatment, it has been already answered. The treatment remains same. It's a, whether it's a GB syndrome or it's a, any other neuromuscular disorder or any, except that in a patient also, all these patients should be put on anticoagulation because of hypercoagulable state.
The complication treatment will be the same because as a primary disease. The thing is, if you are planning a rituximab or a plasma medicine, you have to see depending on the condition.
There is a question for Dr. Ankush, role of IVIG in primary neuropsychiatric systemic lupus erythematosus. Role of IVIG in neuropsychiatric manifestation of SLE. Ankur, are you there? Pravar, if you want to take this question. Alok?
Patients who have SLE and are not responding to steroids, then IVIG would be a natural choice for these patients.
Maybe a neuropsychiatric manifestation, maybe because of steroid only.
So IVIG would be a good choice in patients who are not responding to the first line treatments.
So, couple of months before we discussed this question, and they said the plasmapheresis is still better than the IVIG for management of neuropsychiatric manifestation.
Because IVIG is not well tried in SLE in general.
Yeah.
The last resort, I think we can try.
So, Atma, it's a big question for you. How can treat epilepsy patients? It's only Atma can answer.
Sir, the treatment is at least as far as epilepsy is there, it's almost same as COVID versus non-COVID. The only thing is a patient with COVID and developing epilepsy, then at least we should try to have imaging. But bleed, for some of the patients we have found bleed also, even ICA. Some of the patients that I mentioned about CVT and stroke. So that should be ruled out, otherwise treatment will be more or less safe as non-COVID.
The only small point is these drugs which you use for epilepsy, there are some drug interactions with remdesivir, which is commonly used, and also with chloroquine, which is being used commonly in COVID patients. So you should be cautious.
Prolongation, especially with lacosamide and those drugs we can avoid. If somebody is taking SC2S or azithromycin, then lacosamide is one drug which we should be very cautious.
So there is another question, the treatment of multiple sclerosis patient in COVID-19.
Treatment of MS patient with COVID-19, I think it's COVID-19 is just a bystander. The treatment is same as the MS patient. Anything else, we are already cautioned. Like the patient is on a rituximab and he comes for follow-up for rituximab. Possible if they, you can avoid for a few weeks until this COVID-19 symptoms are monthly goes off. Otherwise, other treatments, I don't think there is any harm or any record which is there. Actually, there is a review article in Green, both in Green Neurology and Lancet Neurology of the people of MS with the COVID. Except for rituximab, all other drugs, maybe some of the newer like severe cases, they are using other drugs which should be careful. Otherwise, the routine routine treatments which you are using for MS may not be stopped with somebody as a COVID.
Yeah, Prabhar, if you want to add on anything, because you were recently
I would just want to add that there is a very slight evidence, very small and subtle evidence that teriflunomide and interferons might actually be helpful in COVID infections. So those are the MS treatments which might be slightly helpful in clearing the SARS coronavirus 2 in these patients. And otherwise, I agree with Bichiraj about rituximab. One, if you can just play around and delay or increase the interval with rituximab, that's the only change that you might have to make. Otherwise, treatment remains pretty much the same.
So the last question. We have got a little time with us now. Last question is, what's the role of colchicine in treating a COVID-19? Anyone wants to take this question? Colchicine in a COVID-19, management of COVID-19. Any idea?
Actually, colchicine has been tried as a rescue medication in some of the countries, but I don't think it has a widespread usage. Mm-hmm. Actually, coming to the primary treatment, whether it is colchicine or hydroxychloroquine or even the fibivir, none of these have shown to have a very remarkable response. Only these are used as rescue medication. People say HCQO and the cause. Hydroxychloroquine is the cause of increased mortality in health workers. Because most of these patients have increased mortality when compared to the non-health workers. So we don't know, we don't have a last answer. Only thing which I found out, which is very simple to use, not much of side effects, is the ivermectin. So, ivermectin may be more used nowadays, even it has been used for ivermectin in use for prophylaxis.
Yes.
So, day 1, day 7, and day 38. Colchicine, people have used as rescue medication. I don't think any trial, whether you give any treatment or don't give treatment, because we don't have any double blind studies to say any of these are.
So, my final question to Dr. Sudhir Gupta is, what if you will leave India, go to Nepal or Sri Lanka, settle down there for a couple of months, and come down when the vaccine is available? What's the idea, Dr. Suresh?
First of all, you have to follow quarantine before you go.
How many days?
14 days.
Okay. So thank you all. It's better than an IPL match, and that's lots of learning, hell of a learning. Thank you very much from my side. It's a goodbye. Bye-bye.
Bye. Bye.